Hi Year 6, I hope you're all well. For today's PE lesson, we are going to be doing an athletics lesson. Okay, you're going to improve three main athletics events. So that'll be running, jumping and throwing. And before we start getting to our warm-up and main activity, there's three PE at home checks we need to do to make sure that we stay safe. Okay, the first one is making sure that we have a safe area that you're going to be participating in. So make sure there's no objects that you could hurt yourself on. Make sure that the area is flat as well. Second thing is making sure we're in appropriate PE wear. So make sure you've got a sports top on, sports shorts or bottoms. And the third and last thing is making sure you have a bottle of water close by, because there's going to be times in the lesson where you can pause the video, go get yourself a drink, have a little break. Once you've done them three things, let's get started in our warm-up. So warm-up today, we're going to go through three different movements just to increase that heart rate, to get our body temperature up so we're ready for our main activity. Again, we don't want to hurt ourselves. We want to prevent injuries as much as we can. To do this, we need to do a warm-up. Warm-up's going to be a lot shorter than our normal warm-up is in PE, because again, these videos aren't as long as our normal PE lessons. Okay, so three movements to increase our heart rate, to warm our body up. The first movement is going to be a simple jog on the spot. The second movement will be a squat jump. The third movement is going to be a side shuffle. Now, if you don't know what one of these movements are, don't worry, because you're going to be following along with me for the warm up. Once we've finished, you'll get a drink, and then we'll get into our main activity. So if you've got a safe space, let's get started. Remember, the first movement was a simple jog. So follow along, make sure you're working hard today. Do a quick warm-up. Focus on athletics today. So you're running, throwing, and jumping events. Make sure you're pumping them arms, driving them knees. Okay, squat jump, so squat down, and then jump up. So bending them knees, keep that back straight, head looking forward. Use your arms, take a bit of upward momentum. Good, into a side shuffle. Right to left, keep that body facing forward. Feet go in and then out. Shuffle sideways, just use your arms. Get your arms involved if you want to. Good, that's set one. We're going to do three sets back into the middle, into a nice slow jog. It's too hard for you, slow down. Okay? It's just a warm-up. Fantastic. Now into our squat jump. So squatting down. Explosive up. Bending the knees. Don't bend your back, bend your knees. Side shuffles. Go. Squat jumps, shoulder, leg, shoulder width apart, up and down. Side shuffles, hold up, keep going. Last movement, and have a break. Get yourself some water. Okay, pause the video, go get a drink, come back, let's get into our main activity. Right, year six, so you should have paused the video, and I've got a quick drink. Let's get into our main activity now. Like I said, we're working on athletics and the key skills within athletics, running, jumping, and throwing. So for the main activity, the starter activity, we're just gonna work on our technique. So that's really important for us to get right at the start, because if we haven't got good technique, we're not going to perform to the best of our ability. Okay, and that's what's going to let us down when we're doing these events. Okay, Let's start with the sprinting. So we're gonna do everything on the spot. Okay, you don't need to be moving around, don't need loads of space. If you are doing this outside, fantastic. You can maybe use the space a little bit better. But remember, I'm trying to do these videos to people that don't have the space, that have very little space, okay? So what you're gonna do for the sprinting, we're gonna start with that. You're gonna sprint on the spot for about 20 seconds, okay? Let's go through the technique of a sprint. We need to make sure we keep our body straight. It's one of the first things that we need to do. Arm pump is very important. So swinging them arms down the side of our body, making sure we're rotating from the shoulder, not the elbow. If we rotate from the elbow, it's like we're cutting wood. We want to rotate from the shoulder, okay? We should be able to, when we're running, see our wrists coming up the side of our head here. So, arm pump is really important, keeping the body, our body straight. Head needs to be looking forward. If we're looking down at the floor, we're not in a nice upright position. Upright position is gonna allow us to run properly in a good running, and allow us to do our good running technique. So make sure you're upright, head looking forward. The next thing is our knee drive. We need to drive our knees upwards and forwards. Okay, and then we run on the balls of our feet. So if we add all them together, okay, we're doing this position here. So again, I want you to sprint on the spot for 20 seconds, have a little rest, do it again. I want you to do it 4 times. Think about the technique, try and keep everything straight. Should look like this from the side. Okay, driving the arms, pumping the arms, driving the knees. Okay, year 6, so you should have stopped the video and done your 4 sets of 20 second sprints on the spot, focusing on your technique. Now gonna move on to a standing long jump, so our jumping phase in our athletics lesson today. Gonna do a standing long jump, so that means 2 feet on the floor, okay? No movement, no momentum will be done from a run up, so we're standing and we're jumping as far as we can. Could use maybe an object just to put on the floor to jump from. Okay, so you start behind that object, jumping as far as we can. Let's talk about the technique. First thing, we need to create tension in our muscles, in our legs, to gain power and to jump as far as we can. So to create tension in our legs, we need to bend our knees. Okay, so that's the first thing. I want you to think about bending our knees in a starting position. Then we need to think about how we gain forward momentum. To do that, remember we're not running, so to do that, we need to swing our arms. Okay, so arm swing will be back and then upwards and forwards. Okay, too many people kind of swing forwards like that. We need to jump upwards as well. The longer we stay in the air, the longer we can travel forwards. So our arm swing should be up and forwards up here, above my head, bending our knees. Make sure your toes are pointing forward. Keep that back straight, because we don't want to be in this position here, because then we're using a lot of our force to get upright. So start nice and upright, swinging our arms back and jumping as far forward as we can. So pause the video, I want you to do it at least 6 times, so 6 practices, focusing on just your technique, not your distance. Off you go. Last one now, gonna be our throwing phase in our athletics lesson. Now, it needs to be careful. It's going to be quite hard for us to practice throwing a ball, because obviously a throwing event in the Olympics or athletics is done over distance. Now, if you're in your lounge, in your bedroom, there's not much distance. So again, we're just really focusing on technique at the moment. I'm lucky enough to have a crash mat off screen, so there I'm going to be throwing my ball into that. If you maybe have something that you can throw your ball into, that mum, dad, whoever looking after you, it's fine for you to throw a ball into that. You might even roll up some socks. So if you don't have a ball, you'll be throwing with a pair of socks. So they're soft. So if you're throwing it into maybe a sofa, something soft that your mum, dad allows you to do, so make sure you check with them. If not, then all I want you to do is do it shadow. So what that means is pretending that you're throwing. Okay, because again, we're just working on our technique. Okay, so I'm gonna throw into a crash mat. I'm lucky enough to be at school and have these facilities to do these videos. Okay, first thing we need to do is find that side position. It needs to be side on. So again, I'm throwing this way. So I've got my leading foot out, pointing to where I want to throw it. I'm dominant in my right hand, so my right arm is stronger. So I'm going to be throwing with that. Obviously, we need to do, depending on the throw, we're just going to practice an overarm throw. Okay, so the ball needs to be above my shoulder. The reason we start side on is because I want to use, okay, or gain force from my tummy, my abs, when I rotate. So that's going to gain force in my throw. Obviously, the force in my arm is going to be power as well. And there's one more place, where do you think that might be? Okay, one more place on my body that's going to gain me power and force. Hopefully you said legs, okay, because that's going to be another place. Now, we're not going to do a run-up throw. It will be a standing. We're going to allow you to rotate and step through with your back foot. Okay, so a throw with power should look like this. Ball starts up nice and high, and we swing and rotate through here. Okay? Now, if you don't have the facilities or equipment available to you to do this, I want you just to shadow throw. So again, no equipment in your hand, but you're trying to just practice the technique. Remember to rotate that core, strong arm, push all the way through to your target, step with that back foot as quick as you can. Timing is really important. I want you to do about 10 throws. Remember, if you can't use anything to throw against, just do a shadow throw for me. 10 throws, off you go. Okay, Isaac, so you've just had a go at each event, practicing your techniques. Remember, that's one of the main important things when doing these athletics events. I'm going to set you a challenge like any PE at home lesson finishes with a challenge. Remember to record your challenges or try and show evidence that you're completing them. Send them to your year group email. So I really want to see how well you do in these challenges. You're going to be competing against each other. So listen carefully to the rules. So I want to try and make it as fair as possible. Now, obviously, some of you have gardens to use, some of you have bigger lounges, and so on. So I'm trying my best to make it as fair as possible. Now, obviously, I can't make it exactly the same for everyone, so just try your best, record your score as correctly as possible. Again, videos are great because I can see you doing them. So event one is running. Okay, you're going to sprint on the spot for as long as you can. Now, it needs to be a sprint because you're racing against each other. So I can't have you jogging on the spot because you can jog for a long period of time. You need to sprint on the spot for as long as you can. So you need a helper for this one, okay, to record your time. You're running or sprinting on the spot as fast as you can, but for as long as you can. So it will be recorded and measured on time. So how long it takes you or how long you can sprint on the spot, okay? Second event is a standing long jump. So you're going to stand behind an object, jump, standing long jump, so no run up, and jump as far as you can. You're then going to measure your distance in some way. If you have a measuring tape, fantastic. Maybe an A4 sheet of paper, see how many sheets you can get in between the object and you. Because again, that's an easy way for me to know the distance, okay? And the third one is throwing. Now that's the hardest one. Some of you have big gardens. Some of you can only do these PE lessons in your room. So what I've come up with is you're gonna be throwing a paper aeroplane. Okay, because they can't go really far, but it really makes you focus on your technique. Okay, just like a javelin, you can't throw a javelin the same as you throw a tennis ball using the same techniques. Just doesn't work. Javelin throw has a specific technique. Okay, you need to keep that javelin as straight as possible as you travel through your throw. Bit like a paper aeroplane, so that's why we're using that. So again, throwing your paper aeroplane as far as you can. Okay, and then in some way you're going to measure how far you threw it. Again, please record. Please send them into your year group email. Good luck with the challenge.